And the wonders of video editing have brought you right back here into this hallway. I brought us to this hallway instead of the fight because there's a few things I need to point out before we go into the fight. Number one, I'm low on supplies. I forgot to stock up. Number two, we are all level 33 now. I went out, I did some grinding. I went from 27 to 33 on all of my people. That's about the highest I could get, really, because the highest someone I could find was a level 30 in all the wards I tried. So this was as high as I could get myself. I got Dante's Blades. I got that from farming a Tetra shell, one of the big armored knight dudes. This is the, what is basically one of the top tier weapons in the game. Its only competitor is one that basically just has two more attack than it, but a little less accuracy. So it's pretty good. The Quake Beast Fur, I don't know if I showed that. I don't know if you guys, yeah, I think you guys were there for that. Did anything else change? Oh, the Dryad's Blade for Black Rose. It is a very good weapon for her. Got it from a chest at the end of a dungeon. Gives her Jacques Smash and Jacques Dive. Both wood attacks kind of sucked on some of these fights because they're one of the areas I was grinding has a monster called the Dark Phoenix. Completely tolerant, complete tolerance to wood. Fucking sucks. Could not find a weapon for Mistral as hard as I tried. Didn't feel like farming for it, so there's that. We're gonna try the scape fight again. I did look up a strategy on how to try to do this. They told me to bring Mistral instead of Gardenia because Mistral will give you all the super duper uber awesome heals. And basically the plan is to go in and DPS the fuck out of them and have Mistral on heals and on occasion have her attack. Yeah, skip that. We saw that. So what we're gonna do is we're in here, immediately set her to freaking, we already have her set to heals. I have no idea how long it takes to get him down to a social. Oh shit, get away! Woohoo! Missed me, bitch! I went back in too soon, damn it. Go ahead and put that on me. I don't know how long it takes to get a data drain on this guy, but, shit! Judgment is unblockable, as is data drain. The earthquake gets blocked for, though. Data drain's obviously unblockable because of how it operates, but this one, just because it freezes you, and it's a water-based attack, which reminds me, something I want to try. I got this scroll in a dungeon, no idea what the fuck it does. Gonna try it! Didn't do Jagged Lily. Resurrect, Mistral. Health drink, Rose. 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 Mistral. Take this Mage's Soul. Keep doing that first aid shit. Get away! Here's the other Rose. Check back in. Basically, everything I read basically said just do hit and run tactics. I have resurrects given to every character, except I think Rose only has a few. It'll keep me going, just in case I die instead of one of them. I give everybody health drinks, so that should push come to shove. We can all dish out some heals. Unfortunately, you can't buy health potions, which sucks. I came in here with 99, but carving through these monsters in this dungeon, even with as strong as I am in levels, is not easy. Apparently Skaith is like a super duper hard boss to beat. Not even because he's hard, but he's just he's like a tank. Come on, heal it. Yes. Don't need area information. Mage's Soul. Mistral. Keep healing. Oh, one of my skill drains went off. Oh, back up. I wish I could command Rose to get the hell out of there. I hit that too early. There we go. Give me a Mage's Soul to Mistral. Kind of maxed out. Once we find, if we can ever get him in a data drain, which is what he's gonna fucking do to us now, he has approximately 4,500 health. So that's gonna be tough to cut down through. I have, wow, okay. Somebody was packing a damn antidote. Cannot do that while dead. Fuck!
me.
Come on, somebody hit me. Come on. I gave you all resurrects. Come on, people. I gave you resurrects for this exact reason. You have resurrects. What the hell? Yes, I know what judgment does. Yes, we're back. Come on, stop being dead. Stop being dead. Yes! Alright, first thing here's Major Soul on me. Health drink. Health drink. Doing an earthquake. Hit Black Rose. And I think it just barely hit Master. So we're gonna heal. Another judgment. Let's survive through that. Judgment doesn't hit too hard. And more magic armor for Rose. See? She takes so much damage from that. I'll let Mistral heal it up. We've got a second. By hitting with some skills. See if we can't get some extra damage in for that data drain. Ow! First aid. Run. Shit. Data drain. Is he gonna hit? He hit me again. Oh, this is gonna suck. Oh, I got that. I did that health drink just in the nick of time. Come on. Another judgment. That's gonna hit Black Rose hard. Mitchell's got pretty good magic defense, I remember, right? Let's see, that does. Wow, never mind. That does a shit ton of damage to her. Shit. Can't be that far. Oh shit! I cannot be that far away from a data drain. Once he's at a data drain, it's gonna be easy to chip him away. I can just start spamming skill attacks on him. Shit, another judgment. Isn't that a close range? No, it's a damn. It's a whatever the hell kind of range I want it to be. Attack. Wrong fucking item. Rose. Mistral, should do some healing. How far out can I be from this, dammit? I can't be that far out from a data drain. Shit, I... You know, when I said that, I meant I wanted the data drain, and he data drained me. I need to soul, Mistral. Think shit! Should've given that, should've sent that heal my way. Alright, thank you, Mistral. Type break! You're mine! And fire! Gotcha, bitch. Score F. Hit him. Ow! Okay, he's still dangerous. Hey, buddy, hit him with some skills. I've got twin darkness. Oh, we're already kicking ass here. Shit. No, 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 no. Come back. Another twin darkness. Oh, I took some damage here. And I need to get out of it to heal. I need to get out of this attack to heal. First aid. Get that out. I am out of SP. Damn it. Major soul. Major soul. This. I have not felt this tense in a boss fight since I was fucking raiding Ice Crown Citadel back in during WoW. First time in a long time I've actually felt this tense in a boss fight. Although we already got him to half. Ah! Damn it, I timed that just right. That would've really bad. Let's see how much Blazing Wheel does. Ooh, Blazing Wheel does about 500. That's a nice one. Too bad I can only use two before I need another Mage's Soul. Ah! get Mishra back up. Back up, back, 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 back. Everybody back. Come on. It's dangerous to be this close to him. We don't have a healer up. The Blazing Wheel. That only did about 100 that time. Fuck. No, that's gonna hit us with some kind of attack. Damn it! Mistral's down again. Up, Mistral, come on. I'll heal what I can, but I'm running low on these. Come here, asshole. Twin Darkness! Ah! Right, she's sending out a Lara up. Who's she gonna hit with that? Sidequake, thank you. Don Rose, he's over here. Ah, fuck, he can heal too. Thankfully, it's only about 150. Unless that was me who healed. Yeah, that was me who healed, never mind. This health has changed. Back up! Mage's Soul. Adjust my damn headset. Right, go back in. Another Twin Darkness. I think we can get away with another one. Let's put this on here real quick. Shit. Finish this. Damn it. Yes!
Kubia. We had come so far, but we knew so little, and now the true battle was about to begin.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has been Dot Hack Infection. Next up, we have Dot Hack Mutation, if I believe right. Hold on. No. No. Hold on. Yeah. Fuck, now we're going up. It is... Mutation. Yeah, that's part two. Mutation, everybody. Mutation will be coming up within the next few days. I haven't got a chance. Obviously, since I just finished this, I haven't started recording that yet. But it's obviously going to take me a while to edit all this up. And plus, I've still got to record some Brotherhood as well. But I have no fear. Mutation will be out within the next week. On to the game. This is my first full playthrough of Infection. Last time I played this, like, I maybe did like the first few levels. Like, that scene right there basically tells you how far into the game I made it. The picture with her talking to Kite in his original design, that's basically how far I made it the first time I ever played this game. And the last time I played this game, actually. So, I never made it far. This is my first time hearing the story first person, because I have played the GU series, which takes place, like, 7 years after, I think. I think it takes place, like, 7 years after the original. Maybe less. It might be three years, but I think it's seven. Yeah, I think it's seven. I don't know. But, so I know, like, the highlights, but I don't really know the details of it, and that fight with Scathe is probably one of the best boss fights I've done in a long time. And not because there was some super awesome, like, twist to it, or there's, like, some big trick you had to do to win. It was simply the fact that it's the first boss fight in a long time that made me feel tense. There was actually that fear of losing, because any game, you know, just video game, you know, you lose, you die, you lose, you come back, you try again. However, I think what did it this fight for me was the fact that if I'd lost, if I died again, I had to go through the whole freaking dungeon all over again, and I did not want to do that. I really, really did not want to go through that place again. So tedious, and I lost so many items just getting there. And speaking of item loss, Jesus Christ, I went into that Scathe fight with 60 health drinks. I came out with like 13 or 12. That was freaking amazing. How just freaking by the skin of my teeth. I never understood that phrase. But by the skin of my teeth, I come out of that fight okay. And then we meet this guy who, Miss, I need a shirt, said, called him Cubia, or Cubia, I think. Cubia. I think she said Cubia. Cubia. Call Miss I Need a Shirt, or Helba, as she's called. Calls this guy Cubia, which I'm guessing he's gonna be either the big bad of the next game, or he's the big bad of the series. I can't quite remember. I think he's just like the big bad of this one, and like each game gets its own big bad. But I wonder if that website's still up and running. It's been a few years. You can now have the data flag for Dot Hack Infection. Okay. I'll save that one. Override data. Yes. They're saved. Select a place to save. What? You want me to save again? Why are you making me keep saving? I already did it. So can I continue on from that set? Oh, mail. Roy Bandai, cleared game data. Congratulations on clearing Dot Hack Infection. You now have the data flag for Dot Hack Infection. Game data saved in this condition in yellow can be imported into the next volume. Data without the data flag will not be imported, so please be careful. You may continue with your adventure with the current data. The main story will not proceed. Items and experience obtained after clearing can be imported to the next volume, so you can strengthen your character before you continue with the story. Giant of Heavens. Have you seen the mystical giant in the heavens of Delta area? in the heavens of Delta Arius. According to rumors, the aerial fleet transporting the giant thousands of years ago was in an accident and now wanders with the giant forever. Delta, hideous someone's giant, uses keyword to solve the mystery of the cursed fleet wandering in the heavens. P.S. I forgot to tell you, I added a virus core T in your items. Oh, we have some post-game stuff to do. Okay, I like that. Success in cultivation of apples. Okay. Bigfoot investigation. Okay. So, I guess this is not over. I think I know how to do this. So, I'm going to cut this episode off here. As always, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time on Let's Finish Up .hack infection.